Well, me and the fiddle are all alone. I roam all over from many a town. Seems to me that no one ever cares. When you're lonely and far away, this is a story that I can say. Just me and the fiddle, we're all alone, you see. Back in 1954, when I was in school, I used to get up every morning and listen to an old boy on the radio named Roy Queen. He had him a disc jockey show, and one morning he said, "Here's a new group from Knoxville, Tennessee, and I'm gonna play their record." And he played "Dear Old Dixie," and I fell out of bed and thought I was gonna bounce off all four walls. Oh, I tell you what, I didn't know what to do. Changed my whole life. He says, "This coming Sunday, these boys are going to be up at the Chain of Rocks Park." I conned my mother, taking me and Walter Metcalf up there to see Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs. And I walked out on that little old stage, that little old bandstand, head on in two-tone shoes. Kind of like Bob right there. And Benny Martin, he looked like a Chicago gangster. And he pulled that fiddle out and he cut out on Gray Eagle, and I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. I think right about then I figured I didn't have much of a future as a steamboat pilot. Yeah.